Is Jupiter always good? He's the greatest benefic, so he must be good, right? My Jupiter, Mahadasha, Antardasha, Pratyanta, Sukshma Dasha, whichever Dasha should be the best Dasha of my life, right? But why was it the worst Dasha of my life? Why did I suffer so bad? Why did I lose so many things during this Jupiter, Mahadasha, Antardasha, or Pratyanta? Or maybe even Sagittarius and Pisces Chara Dashas in Gemini. Did you lose something? Was it difficult? Could be sometimes. Let me know in the comments where your Jupiter is and how was your Jupiter Dasha overall. You could say for career it was this, for marriage it was like this, for health it was like this. Three parameters, good enough. All right, so let's try to understand what Jupiter represents actually. Now you may think, oh, we know he represents spirituality, wisdom, and all the good things in life. Well, you're right. But you have to understand that there's a difference between a planet in general and a planet for you. A planet in general can be good or bad, but for you, that planet may be very good, very bad, excellent, or the worst planet. Or it could be just another planet doing not much, either good nor either bad. So then it's very dangerous to make such a statement that Saturn is a natural malefic, so he will always make things terrible for you. Or Rahu will always make things terrible. Or Ketu will always make you headless. Or Jupiter will always give you good things in life. Well, one thing is true, irrespective of your ascendant and your horoscope, that is, natural malefics will give you a difficult ambience. And natural benefics, who are the natural benefics here? Jupiter, Mercury, Venus, Sun, and Moon can also be included in this. And to some extent, Mars also. And primarily, Saturn, Rahu, Ketu, these three are natural malefics. So, one thing which is very true, irrespective of any ascendant or anything else, or any exaltation, debilitation, any placement, is that during the dashas of natural benefics, you get a good ambience. What do you mean by ambience when it comes to astrology? Ambience means the feel-good factor. So, for example, if you may get a promotion in Saturn, or if you may get it in Jupiter, suppose you have these planets in 10th house, Jupiter, Saturn in the 10th, and then their Antardashas get activated, start. So then you might get a promotion in both of these Antardashas. But then what's the difference? The difference is when you get a promotion during Saturn, it will be after a lot of hard work and perseverance. And the people that you might manage may not like you very much sometimes, or you may not like them very much sometimes, or you may not get perks and allowances. There may not be very much freedom there. But when it comes to Jupiter, you might get a lot of perks, a lot of freedom, you might get fancy gadgets, and the people might like you there. So that's like the ambience. But now, the most important thing is not the nature of the planets. The most important thing in astrology is the houses which the planet indicates. So, what do I mean by this? I mean to say this in simple terms that if you have a malefic in the 10th and the 11th, for career finances, it's great. Even a benefic is great, of course. But what I'm telling is if you have a malefic in 10th or 11th, and you have a benefic like Jupiter, Mercury, Venus in Dusthanas. So don't think that that was a malefic, so that dasha will not be so good. Okay, and this is a benefic, so it will be very good. Don't think like this necessarily. So the first criteria to judge a planet is the houses that it rules and the house where it is placed and the nakshatra lord. So that is and was and will always be the first criteria. That is why, suppose if your Jupiter is in the 8th house, in the nakshatra of the 6th lord or 8th lord or 12th lord, then that dasha can wreak havoc in your life. Okay, even though it's Jupiter, because he is signifying bad houses, difficult houses. Okay. Now, some people will say in Kali Yuga that, no house is bad, you know, don't criminalize houses, blah, blah, blah. Well, you could give a philosophical lecture, but when these dashas get activated, you suffer in life. Okay. So from that context, I'm saying, I'm not saying they are bad for your overall well-being, but there's some level of suffering which nobody likes. Let's not pretend. Let's be honest here, right? Nobody likes suffering. So from a suffering perspective, the dusthanas are not good. Now you may say, later on you may grow in life or whatever. I mean, that lecture you can always give, you know. Oh, ultimately God takes away for your good. Ultimately whatever happens is for your good. You know, you can always give so many explanations and reasonings and justifications that we can always do to pacify our mind. But when that happens at that time, nobody likes that, right? So therefore, now regarding Jupiter, when can Jupiter be behaving in a way which you don't like? Okay. Now, there's one long way to know this, and there's a short way to know this. See, Jupiter in the horoscope will represent optimism basically, and there are many other planets and houses which will represent, like the second house, the fifth house, and the ninth house. These three houses will tell you how much optimistic you are in life in general. Yeah. Why do I say this? Because the fifth house is the house of the soul. How much energy do you have, okay, in life to go ahead? That's what is the fifth house. Then fifth house is also the reason why you get up in the morning. People who have a not so nice fifth house may not have a not so nice morning. They may be they may get up and they may feel that, oh, we don't want to get up, you know, life's not worth getting up. Doesn't mean that you want to commit suicide, but there's no motivation in life to do anything. It's like, you know, as they say, na karna padta hai, that one. I'll just pause it. So what's the shortcut to check your Jupiter? As I said, the second, fifth, and ninth. So fifth house I already said. Then the ninth house shows how much awareness do you have at a spiritual level of divinity. Okay. And then the second house is the house of belonging, basically. And it's not surprising that Jupiter is the karaka for all the three houses. So apart from Jupiter, you can check these three houses, the second, fifth, and ninth. Now, the lords of these houses and the planets place this. So they will give you a story of what's exactly going on. Now, if you have checked all these four, okay, Jupiter, the second house, fifth house, ninth house, and to some extent, you can check your ascendant lord also. That will also tell you how much idealistic you are. So if you feel that you want to check your Jupiter, then you check all this and then you try to analyze yourself, your own mind, your own intelligence, and try to check how much realistic optimism do you have. You may think, what the hell is this realistic optimism? Realistic optimism means, see, everybody is optimistic to some extent, right? But the question is, are you realistic when you are optimistic? People think optimism comes from Jupiter and realism, you know, being realistic comes from Saturn. Well, actually not. That could happen at a gross level. But even a healthy Jupiter will not make you unrealistically optimistic. Like, let me give you a very simple example. One example of a very, very, very bad Jupiter is being optimistic that you can study one night before the exam and crack it. That's an example of a bad Jupiter. Now, why does that happen? Because the person has some level of optimism, right? Yes, I will study today night and tomorrow is the exam. I will do it. Yes, finally. But the thing is that realistic? Now, you may say, oh, yes, I did it. But then you may not get very good grades. Okay? So that's like an example of a very bad Jupiter, because it is making you optimistic in the wrong direction, actually. Okay? It is giving you a false hope, a false optimism, because of which you are actually ruining your life. Okay? So therefore, if you really want to enhance your Jupiter, you must try to develop realistic optimism. And on the other side, another symptom of a very bad Jupiter is you don't have any optimism. You're always pessimistic. That's typical Saturn, okay? Pessimism basically. So that's the other extreme. So now people can have different, a bad Jupiter can have many symptoms. Okay, one of the symptoms, as I said, is there's optimism, but it's not realistic. The other one is you don't have any optimism. You are pessimistic all the time. The other one is you are not pessimistic, nor you are optimistic, but you don't have any drive in life. So it's like saying at times you're optimistic, at times you're pessimistic, but there's no clear direction, there's no clear goal in life. Okay, so that is another symptom of a very bad Jupiter. Okay? So therefore, if Jupiter signifies difficult houses, the Dostanas especially, then you can have these traits. So do not think that Jupiter is always going to be good, blah 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 for me. Now, why does that happen? Because in your past lives, you have used whenever Jupiter Dasha or Jupiterian traits, you have used them very badly. Okay, you might have disrespected the sadhu, the course people who are pursuing spiritual knowledge or who are sharing. So generally, if Jupiter is bad, then this happens that you lack optimism in life. You are like, I just don't want anything in life. I'm done with life. Okay, and you cannot take things in the right perspective. Even if, for example, if something bad happens to you, then you'll start cursing God. You'll start blaming God. This bloody God, he's such a useless God. He's like punishing me for no reason. You may blame the planets, my God. Why God? There are planets. There's only one God, but then you have nine planets, you see. So you will very happily, like I get almost 300 to 500 comments every day in my channel, and I keep seeing people. They are just criticizing, blasting the planets like anything. Oh, this bloody Saturn ruined my life. Shani Maharaj, ye le gaye mere se, wo le gaye, ye kar diya, wo kar diya. Ketu has done this. Rahu ne ye kar diya, usne wo kar diya. So that's a typical symptom that your Jupiter is badly placed. And if you continue to blame like this, then you will even worsen your Jupiter, irrespective of whichever planet you criticize like this. Okay. So if you read the 10th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, there's a very beautiful verse. Tatte anukampam susumikshamano bhunja naivat makritam vipakam ridvag vapubhir vididham namaste jivetayo mukti pade sadaya bhag. Lord Brahma prays to Lord Krishna. He says, oh my dear Lord, that one who accepts all the difficulties and hardships that come in his life as a part of his own karma and does not blame anybody has the right to claim liberation. He is praying to Lord Krishna. Such a beautiful prayer. So therefore, one of the best ways to improve our Jupiter is to be optimistic, but be realistic and understand that whatever is happening in your life, it's because of me and my karma. I am the culprit. You have to accept that. Okay, culprit doesn't mean, again, in a pessimistic sense, oh, I'm the culprit, I'm good for nothing, I'm useless, I'm stupid. No, not in that sense. The right attitude to understand this is that yes, I have made some bad decisions in my life. Because ultimately, what's life? Life is a bag of decisions, right? It's a product of your decision. That's all. That's life. So you might have made some very bad, terrible, horrendous decisions because of which you are now suffering. Okay? Everybody has suffered. I have suffered. You have suffered. Your friends, your family, everybody has suffering, right? So therefore, this is a quick way to check how Jupiter is. Okay? So as I said, that's a very big remedy for Jupiter. And one of the other big remedies is that you stay with people who are optimistic. Okay? If you're staying with your materialistic friends in the materialistic society who are just gossiping, discussing, which cricketer got married to which film star, what's going on in the news, and which two countries are going to start world war, discussing, giving opinions, writing things in Facebook over things which you have no damn control. If you're wasting your life like this, then your Jupiter is definitely smashed. Okay, I don't care. It's exalted or debilitated. It is just ruined. All right. And if you visit spiritual communities, you read the Bhagavad Gita, the Srimad Bhagavatam, or the Bible, or the Quran, the Dharmapada, or the Guru Granth Sahib, and you try to elevate your consciousness, Athato Brahma Jigyasa, as the Vedanta Sutra says, all right, meeting spiritual people in the weekends, especially at the least, or you know, once in a month, at the least. So then that's how you improve your Jupiter. And then there are so many other things you can do. I already have a video on remedies for Jupiter, but all the remedies are only sustainable if you have connection with the spiritual community. All right. So therefore, even if you have Jupiter linked with the difficult Dustan houses, then don't get disheartened. You know, don't criticize the planets. Don't criticize yourself also. You know? There's no use of criticizing even yourself. Oh, I wish I had done better. There's no use of saying like this, but the thing is, you can learn the lessons and move ahead in life. Okay? But for that, you need a spiritual community who can support you, help you, uplift you, and encourage you, and appreciate you, and take you way forward. Without that, you can do 1,000 mantras. You may read the Vishnu Sahasranam. You may do so many things. People tell me after seeing your videos, I have started reading Vishnu Sahasranam. I have started reading Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam. Very good. Great. Congratulations. You have done which nobody can do. But you still need the association of a spiritual community. Okay. If you have that, then you tell me after 1 year that I'm still reading. Then I'll be happy. Because I always get these mails where people tell me I've started reading, but then after 3 months they stop. Why? Because in Kali Yuga the willpower is zero, it's minus actually. Okay, so you may start reading Gita, which is very good, it's very divine, instead of reading unnecessary, useless books which have filled out Kali Yuga. It's great to read the Gita, but you must read it under the supervision of a Guru, authorized Vaishnava. Okay, otherwise you will just speculate. Oh, maybe Krishna says like this, maybe he says that, maybe he means this, maybe he wants me to do like this. All right, it's all mental speculation, which is of no good use. Okay, so therefore find a spiritual community in your in your city or in your town, and then try to associate yourself. Right? That is the way to perfection. Otherwise, we just stay and rot here in this material world, life after life after life. All right. Thank you very much for your patience. And if you want a consultation from me, then please go to my website down below. And if you are new to the channel, then please subscribe to it. And if you want to watch other videos on Jupiter, I shall put it here. All right, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him.